Here it is, folks. The highlight of the AMD booth, at least for me, the Ryzen 7 5700 X3D. It may be dressed in the Emperor's new clothes. They didn't have any physical samples here for me to hold, but I'm genuinely stoked on this thing. A new AM4 processor, all these years later, it's clocked a little lower than the 5800 X3D that we know and love, but it has the same great 3D V-cache, and it comes at a gorgeous drop-in replacement for your existing DDR4 platform setup price of $250, making it a no-brainer upgrade for someone who wants to increase their gaming performance, but doesn't want to invest in a whole new motherboard and system memory. I love this move. There's a handful of other new Ryzen 5000 series chips that flesh out their lower end options, but given they're the only ones they bothered to bring to the show, what AMD really wants to talk about is these new Ryzen 7000 CPUs. But first, let me paint a quick segue to our sponsor.
Headphone juice is not something you should be proud of. These are your typical headphones that accumulate heat while you game.
Ew.
Wicked Cushions add a cooling gel to their cushions to keep your ears sweat-free. You can easily replace them on your headset. Check out Wicked Cushions at the link below.
In my hand is the Ryzen 7 8700G, which AMD is calling the next step in personal AI processing. From a CPU standpoint, there's nothing to really set it apart from Ryzen 7000 series. I'm looking at 8 Zen 4 cores, 16 threads, DDR5 memory on the same AM5 platform we're already familiar with. What sets it apart is everything else. Instead of having kind of weak onboard graphics, we're looking at the same RDNA 3 based onboard graphics that we've seen in AMD's mobile chips that power devices like the ROG Ally. So behind me you can see Starfield and Baldur's Gate 3 running on this chip at, okay, admittedly low details, but 1080p 60fps. The games are freaking running without graphics cards. So I think it's fair to say, at least if AMD's performance numbers are to be believed, don't worry, we'll be validating them later, that this is the final nail in the coffin of those entry-level graphics cards that have always offered a really terrible price-to-performance ratio, but now just don't need to exist at all. Moving down to the 8600G, you get some expected reductions in spec, 2 fewer CPU cores, 4 fewer GPU cores, but that same AI NPU processor that we're kind of waiting for software to make use of, but hey, it could come in handy someday. And then as you make your way further down, things get very interesting. The 8500G has 6 cores, just like the 8600G, but 2 of them are traditional Zen 4 cores, while 4 of them are Zen 4 Cs. But before you go, gee, that sounds an awful lot like Intel's hybrid architecture, it's not quite the same. Zen 4C is architecturally the same as Zen 4 and should have the same performance at the same clock speed, but the difference is that they're crammed in tighter, meaning that they tend not to turbo up as high, so there is an expected reduction in performance. Also, the 8500G doesn't have the AI processor and has a lesser GPU. Rounding out the lineup is another no-show, the 8300G, which has only 1 traditional Zen 4 core and 3 Zen 4C cores. I'm gonna be really curious to see how that thing performs. One thing I know I'm not gonna like is the name. I don't see how upgrading the onboard graphics and tacking on an AI processor sometimes necessitates an 8000 series, but I guess, you know, sometimes you run out of numbers and you just gotta kinda increase the series, except, no, you don't have to do that. You can tack on letters, like they've done with the 7600 XT. This is a pretty significant upgrade to the existing 7600. Sort of. While you won't find any increase to its stream processor count or compute unit count, there is a bump to clock speeds with the corresponding power bump, and perhaps most importantly, an increase from 8 gigs of GDDR6 memory to 16 gigs of GDDR6 memory, which, as we've seen from our benchmarking of this card, can make a pretty big difference in games that require it. There's a couple other little things to cover. The support for DisplayPort 2.1 UHBR10 is now mandatory rather than being optional like it was with the 7600. And the price is $330, meaning that you are looking at a pretty darn good 1440p gaming experience, even in demanding games like Starfield for a pretty reasonable price. This is running at 1440p, right? Low, but yes.
I
Are your headphones cushions hot like a tiny steam room?
Stop steaming your ears like your broccoli. Wookie cushions offer all sorts of cushion replacement for your headphones.
And it's not just your regular cushions.
With added dual-layer cooling gel, they ensure you keep a cool head even your team is skidding.
Looking for a crack? Wookie cushion gives you a crack-free comfort.
They use top-notch materials like breathable sport fabric and memory foam.
With over 25,000 reviews and a 365 days to fall in love warranty,
don't listen to me, listen to your ears this time.
Check out Wicked Cushions at the link below.
They had some other cool stuff in the booth, like the Framework 16 modular gaming laptop, but I think that's gonna be a dedicated video, so I'll see you over there.